Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_028_BIAD where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. If you don't have access into this exercise file, you can use your own file or just sit down and watch. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as button. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_029_BIAD and click the save button. Go to the view cube and click the right view. Go to the top right corner and click. Move a crossing window to select the top part of the building. Be careful not to select the bottom part, only halfway through the building, and click. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, hide object. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select the slab, right click, isolate, hide object. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Now we want to get our stairs. So go to the visual style control, click realistic and select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. At the select object on the layer to be isolated point, click on this object and press enter. AutoCAD isolates this object. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer property. This brings the layer property manager. Click the new icon. Now type 3D stairs. Click the color swatches to change its color. You can assign any color that you want. I'm going to select the index color 25. That way it has a thicker color than the 2D stairs. Now click OK to close the select color dialog box. Close the layer property manager. Go to the quick access toolbar and make the 3D layer the current layer. If you are using a previous release of AutoCAD, you may not have this option in your quick access toolbar. So go to the layer property manager and do the same. Right click the UCS and select the 3-point option. As a specified new origin point prompt, go and turn off the auto mode on your status bar or click the F8 key. Move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. At the specifying positive position of x-axis point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. At the specified positive y position of the UCS x and y plan, go on and turn on the auto mode and move the mouse cursor vertical to the screen and click. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the polyline command. Zoom in into this area. At the specified start point prompt, click and move the mouse cursor up. Type 6 inches, press enter. Move it to this direction and type 9 inches, press enter. Up 6 inches, press enter. Continue until you get to the last point. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline command. At the specified start point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this endpoint. And turn off your auto mode on the status bar, and move the mouse cursor and snap into this corner. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance point, type 6 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it now. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and erase it. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and start the polyline command. At the specified start point, click here and move the mouse cursor. Click anywhere around this area. press escape to get out of it. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillets command. Type R for the radius and press enter. Type 0, press enter. Type M and press enter. Select this line and this line, this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. At the select object to extrude prompt, select the polyline that you just create and press enter. Now move the mouse cursor and snap into this angle. Go to the visual style and click the 2D wireframe, select realistic. Select these tiers. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base points of displacement point, zoom in into this area and click on this vertex. At the specified second point, move the mouse cursor and snap tiers into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the rotate command. At the select object prompt, select these tiers and press enter. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this area. Now turn on your auto mode on the status bar or press F8 key. Move your mouse cursor into this direction until the staircase orients like mine. Click. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select the staircase. Go to the home tab. Modify panel and select the move command. At the specified base point prompt, click on this line. At the specified second point, move the mouse cursor and click on this line. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, end objects isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, on isolate. Zoom in into this area. We need more work to complete into this area. Zoom in into this area. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Draw a line from this point and move the mouse cursor out. Press escape. Press enter. Start the line from this point and go out. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, move the mouse cursor and click on this wall. At the specified extrusion height point, move the mouse cursor and snap perpendicular to the bottom edge of this slab, not this top edge, to the bottom edge of the slab. Press escape to get out of the command. Now if you look at this step, you need one more step to get to the top of the slab. To correct this problem, first, let's select this slab and erase it. Select these tiers, go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap into this vertex. At the specified second point prompt, move the mouse cursor and snap into this other vertex. Press escape to get out of it. Now we need to remove this portion of the wall into this area. To do that, select this step, hold down your control key and control plus the shift key, type C on your keyboard. At the specified base point prompt, zoom in into this area and snap into this area. Press escape. Now we're going to subtract this step from this solid. When we do, AutoCAD gets rid of this step. So we bring back the step that we copy to the clipboard by pasting it in the same place. Go to the home tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this solid, press enter. Then select this stairs, press enter. AutoCAD remove the stairs from this object. Now type oops on your keyboard to bring the object that will erase last. Hold down your control key and type V on your keyboard. At the specified insertion point prompt, move your mouse cursor into this area and click to paste the stairs. Now we need to move this slab backward 9 inches. To do that, we're going to use the press pull command. But first, let's draw a reference line to divide this face. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified start point, use the endpoint object file to snap into this vertex. Now move the mouse cursor into the Z direction and click. Press Escape. Zoom in into this area. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the Press Pull command. At the Select Object or Bounded Area prompt, move the mouse cursor and hover it to this face. Move it back. Type 9 inches to press this slab. Press Escape to get out of the command. Now, go to the Visual Style Control and change it back to 2D wireframe. Select this step. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. At the specified base point front, select the stairs from this point and move it into the vertex of this slab. Change the visual style back to realistic and see the result. Change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Hold down your Shift key and orbit so that you can see the stair in this area clearly. We'll move this stair from this point to this point, then we'll move it back 6 inches to avoid the wall. Because this slab cuts through the wall, select the stairs, go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. At the specified base point prompt, move the mouse cursor into this area and click. At the specified second point prompt, move and use the endpoint object map to snap into this place. Press Enter to repeat the Move command again. Select the stairs and press Enter. At the specified base point prompt, zoom out, click anywhere in the drawing area. At the specified next point, move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 6 inches. Press Enter. Go to the visual style, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Now we need to trim off the stair keys. We have a reference line already in place. All you need to do is select this line and extend it into this direction. Press Escape. Now draw another line, temporal line, at a specified start point. Use this endpoint and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Type 8 feet on your keyboard, press Enter. Press Escape. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the Extrude command. Add the Select Object to Extrude prompt. Select this line, press Enter, and type P on your keyboard, press Enter. Click this object. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the Slice command. At the Select Object to Slice prompt, select the stairs, press Enter. Type H on your keyboard and press Enter. Select the surface, press Enter. Now select the surface and hit Delete on your keyboard. Select the top part of the stairs and hit Delete. Select all the temporal line that we draw and delete them. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, in this tutorial we grade our internal stairs. In the next tutorial we'll continue to modeling our stairs by gritting railings and cut an opening for the cutting wall. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your colleague. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment. If you want to follow along in this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye. See you in the next class.